Hello, a very warm welcome to a session on Tableau filters. This is Dr. Anita Pujar, Professor in Computer Science and Engineering Department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of the session, students are able to demonstrate how filters are used to generate the extracts of data, as well the working of different types of filters. Filters are mainly used for analyzing the data in different manner. Tableau filtering feature allows three types of basic filters: filter dimensions, that is, this is applied on dimension fields; filter measures, applied on measures; filter dates, applied on date fields. Now let's start with filter dimensions. We will start with objective. Apply dimension filters on the subcategory of products according to their shipping mode on the data source superstore.xls. Now this superstore.xls comes with the Tableau, so we will be using the same data source. So to achieve this objective, we have to perform the following steps. Drag the dimension field subcategory to the row shelf and measure field profit to the column shelf to create a view. Drag the subcategory dimension to the filter shelf so it opens the filter dialog box. Now click the None button at the bottom of the list to deselect all the segments and select the Exclude option in the lower right corner and choose Labels and Storage. So we are trying to exclude labels and storage from the subcategories of the products. So let's see the screenshot of this. So we see that the view is created with the dimensions, ship mode and subcategory in the row shelf, sum of profit in the column shelf, and we can see the list of the subcategories of the products. Now in the next screenshot, we drag the subcategory to the filter shelf and the filter dialog box opens. Then we choose None from the list. Then we select labels and storage to be excluded from this view. So in the next screenshot, you will find that labels and storage have been excluded. Now moving on to filter measures. These filters are applied on measures. Filtering is based on the calculations applied to the measure fields. For example, consider the same data source, superstore.xls. Apply the dimension filters on the average value of the profits. So here we are applying the filter on the measures. A measure is nothing but average value of the profit. Create a view with ship mode, subcategory and average of profit as dimensions. So this is a screenshot of the view that has been created with all these dimensions. So you can see that in the column shelf there is average of profit and in the row shelf there is subcategory. So a list of subcategories has been displayed. Now, since we are using filter on the measure, so we will be moving the average of profit to the filter shelf. So drag the average of profit value to the filter shelf. Choose the average as the filter mode and choose at least and give a value to filter the rows which meet this criteria. So now we'll see how this can be done in the next screenshot. So this is when the average of profit is moved to the filter shelf. So this dialog box opens. So there are many options in this, such as range of values, at least, at most, and special. So range of values allows you to create a result between the values that you specify here, that is starting value and ending value. At least option provides you to choose all the transactions in the result set which have average of profit at least more than the value that you provide. So it is a minimum value. And similarly, at most is generating the result set where the transactions have the average of profit at the max, that is at most the given value, and so on. So in this screenshot, we are choosing the option at least. So I have provided the value 20 for the average of profit, and below we are choosing only the relevant values. So say OK and apply. So this is the result set that has been generated. So you can see all the subcategories which have the average of profit at least 20. So these are all which have about $20. Now we will move to the third type of filter, that is filtering on dates. Tableau applies a filter on date field in three ways. By taking a relative date, that is as compared to today, that is you can say fourth day or fifth day from today. Then it will apply the filter by taking an absolute date. Then third one is it uses range of dates. So again, for example, we will take the same data store, that is superstore.xls, create a view with order date in column shelf and profit in the row shelf. Now drag the order date field to the filter shelf because you are going to apply the filter on date, and choose the range of dates in the filter box. So let's see how it's done. So this is a screenshot, that is a view created. Here we have taken the order date in the column shelf and sum of profit in the row shelf. So we see that view has been created here, where column wise the years have been shown. Now we drag the date to the filter shelf. So it will open the filters dialog box in this manner. Again, we have various options here. Now in this example, we are choosing the range of dates. So we have to provide the starting date and the end date, which has already been shown here. So here the starting date is 27/3/2012 and the ending date is 11/3/2013. So it will show all the transactions between these dates. Similarly, you can give the relevant date also here, that is starting from today's date, and as well as you can give the starting date option where it shows all the transactions which have been started on this particular date. Similarly, you have ending date, so it will create a results sheet where all the transactions are shown that are within the ending dates and so on. So here, as we have chosen range of dates, so we'll see how the result has been created in this view. So it shows all the orders within the two dates that have been given in the range of dates. Now we will move to quick filters. These filters are quickly available using the right click option on the dimension or measure on which you want to apply the filters. Now, when you right click on any of the dimensions or measures, a list of filters are provided. These have enough functionality to solve most of the common filtering needs. A list of quick filters are displayed as shown below, as shown in the screenshot. So we see that when you right click on the subcategory dimension, it shows all this list of filters. So this list of filters have been shown here, that is single value, which selects one value at a time in the list, single value drop down, which selects a single value in the drop down list, multiple values selects one or more values in the given list, multiple values in the drop down, which selects one or more values in the drop down list, multiple values in the custom list, that is you search and select one or more values here, single value slider, so drag a horizontal slider to select a single value here, wildcard match, that is select values containing the specified characters, that is they are called as wildcard characters. So in this way we have various filters provided immediately at one single right click. That is why it has got the name as quick filters. Now let's see, here we have created a view taking sum of sales in the column shelf and subcategory in the row shelf, and we have dragged the subcategory to the filters. Now filter can be removed by using clear filter option. So go to the filter pane, right click on the field name and choose the clear filter. So as shown in the screenshot, we are right clicking on the filter. We are right clicking on the dimension subcategory, and there you have an option of clear filter. So it will remove the filter on this particular dimension. Now we'll pause a video for a while. Think and write. Which filters provide maximum list of filters that are commonly required for functioning? Just on a single right click on the dimensions and measures on which you want to apply filters. So are those basic filters, context filters, quick filters, or condition filters? So as per the discussion in the previous slides, you have seen that on a single right click on the dimensions and measures, a list of various filters are opened which can be used to be applied on that particular dimensions and measures. And these filters are sufficient for the functioning. They can meet the common requirements of the filters, and they are sufficient for the functioning, and they are nothing but the quick filters. These are some of the references that are used for preparation of this video. Thank you.